The 2015 COSATU Congress adopted a slogan of going back to basics. Can you tell us more about it?
Okay. Now, going back to basic, it means we must go back to where COSATU was formed in 1985. When COSATU was formed in 1985, it was about issues of workers. Not suggesting that the politics were not important, but at that time, we were focusing mainly only on issues of workers. And that's what the Congress says we must do now. Go to individual workplace and make sure that workers' issues are being addressed. That's what we call going back to basic. Recruit, service, retention of our membership.
Now, as you have said that you recruit, you service, and retain your members, what are the methods that COSATU is using to do that?
Well, I'm sure everybody's aware that we have developed a new turnaround recruitment strategy. The turnaround strategy says we must go to workplace and speak to workers and target workers who are unorganized. South Africa has got almost about more than 75% of unorganized workers in South Africa. So we go into the workplace. Whether those workers are organized to COSATU unions or not, we're going to those workers. The method that we're using is to speak to workers about their problems, is to speak to workers about the benefit that they're getting from the trade union movement, and what is that COSATU unions will do when those workers have a problem. But also made commitment to those workers that if the unions of COSATU are not servicing them, nothing stops those workers to come to COSATU. That's why there's a federation. It does what is called political intervention. Not intervening politically on political issues, but doing a political intervention by the leadership of COSATU nationally, provincially, locally on issues that affect workers.
Now, you mentioned that one of the issues you are trying to address is the one of vulnerable workers. We know that currently COSATU is having a campaign of addressing labor brokering, and a lot of workers are complaining about being employed under labor brokers. And COSATU recently said that when workers have been employed for more than 3 months, they should automatically be employed permanently. Now, is this happening? If not, what is COSATU doing to address it?
Let me say, with the current political situation we're facing today in South Africa, with the government of South Africa, each and every worker are vulnerable. But the most workers who are vulnerable are farm workers, retailers, security, domestic workers, the gardening, the cleaning workers, contract workers. But with regard to the labor broker, that's why I'm saying all workers with the current situation we're facing after for the past 5-10 years, let me say from the Polokwane Conference 2007 until today, all workers are vulnerable. Because even in the government, in the public service, there are labor brokers. I'm sure you've seen there in the university in how fighting for insourcing. But what COSATU is doing now, you are correct that the CEC reaffirmed the Congress decision that we must fight and make sure that the labor brokers are banned. The only way to do that is when we take our members to the street. Workers on their own, they will not be able to ban the labor brokers. They will continue to be exploited in terms of the salaries, in terms of not benefiting anything that we've gained in relation to the improving the legislation in South Africa.
Now, we have workers who are watching right now and they're saying, I'm employed by a labor broker, I haven't been paid for so many months. Is there any legal action that I can take? How does the labor law help me to address this issue in my workplace as a worker?
Well, it does. That worker must, whether they are organized into a union or not, it needs CCMA to take that matter. Or the Department of Labor has the responsibility to assist those workers. Any worker who has worked without being paid for 3 months or for 1 month, once you have sold your labor, then the employer must pay you. So, and that's why we're asking our unions, and that's what we call membership service, whether those workers are organized to COSATU union. But once you get the worker says, I've worked for this employer for 2 months, has not paid me, nothing stops me as a trade unionist to go and help those workers to make sure that they get their salaries.
Now, the other issue that is a main problem for them is that when they are retrenched or rather dismissed after the 3 months, they are not given due notice to say, we are not going to renew your contract. Is there anything that they can do to address that or fight that, or there's just no way out of it legally?
Well, it's unfair dismissal. That is why I'm saying the workers are not being given notices, are not given hearing. They're just being asked to leave and say your contract has lapsed.
Mm-hmm.
And in that case, CCMA has a responsibility, or they've got the jurisdiction to make sure that they help those workers on the basis that of the unfair dismissal. But except that, as I said, it is the unions that must fight for those workers to be recognized, to make sure that those workers are reinstated according to the law. And that's why, because I said, we're no longer going to take the issue of the 3 months. What we must do now is to fight for those workers, all of them. Any worker who has been employed as a labor broker was terminated after 3 months. I think COSATU must fight and say those workers, all of them, must come back. They must come back to that employer. And that employer, where he's going to reinstate him is none of our business. The fact that that man or the employer has undermined the laws of this country. The unforeseen circumstances we're facing is because I think it's one of the problems we're facing that we've got weak Department of Labor. Inspectors of our country are not doing their work. They are so weak. They can't focus. When they are supposed to do inspection, they only do inspection on the basis when COSATU asks. They don't just go there every part. I can tell you, if the Department of Labor was able to do their work every day, I'm sure most of the employers by now would have complied in terms of the laws of this country. We're not doing only on the issue of the labor brokers as COSATU. We're fighting also on the poor servicing of workers in relation to the occupational safety. Workers, we've gained, so I heard that we talk about the gains. We've gained a lot of things. We've improved the UIF, we've improved the Occupational Safety Act. As we sit now, the Occupational Safety Act is in the process of being amended. We are now, the CEC says we must also amend the Section 189 in relation to retrenchment. So most of those workers who are employed by labor brokers, they don't see these gates because they are not registered. They can't get UIF, they can't get nothing. Poor women in the vulnerable sector, in the farm workers, they don't know that when they are pregnant or they get miscarriage, if they are stillborn and all they can claim. It's because of the conduct of Department of Labor. It's not the union that must go and workshop. Well, we do agree that we've got part of workshopping our members, but the entire workforce, including those who are not organized with the union, is the responsibility of the Department of Labor.
Now, let's talk more about farm workers. We know that farm workers face a lot of challenges, and this is an old age issue that has been going on. We've seen recently in the media some being assaulted, which is nothing new. Now, how is COSATU helping in this plight? You spoke about the Department of Labor being responsible for workshopping, but COSATU is also playing its role. Now, what role is COSATU playing in all of this?
Well, COSATU is playing a major role than what the Department of Labor is supposed to do. We're continuously making sure that those workers are organized with the COSATU unions, even though we know that over 300 and something thousand workers in South Africa, farm workers, are not being organized because of victimization, because of threat, because of intimidation that they are getting from employers. But COSATU is doing a lot of work for the farm workers, making sure that when those farm workers are assaulted, the police must, COSATU make sure that the police intervene. When workers are evicted illegally, COSATU intervenes to make sure that the Extension of Tenure Security Act is respected. You know that that act is not being respected by farmers. It says when you have worked for a farmer for more than 30, 35 years or more than 5 years, when you're evicted, you must be given a piece of a land to stay there. You're qualified to stay there because you were born there, your parents have died there, and the graves of your parents and your children maybe that there. But what we see today, our government, both labor and land affairs, are not helping workers. So COSATU does its work to make sure that those farm workers are respected as human beings.
Now, you may be having farm workers who are in remote areas where they are not able to easily access COSATU. Where can they go for help when they have the issues that you've just mentioned?
By law, they're supposed to go to the nearest department of labor. But with our workplace visit, that's why we said listening campaign, workplace visit, we go up to rural areas where there are no offices of the Department of Labor, where workers are just in the remote areas. We are going there to make sure that those workers get access of the information, we're able to assist them, but at the same time, we've got locals of COSATU in all the municipalities. The word locals of COSATU should play a central role in making sure that those workers get the information and also be assisted.
Now, you spoke about the extension of security of Turner Amendment Bill. Can you tell us more on how this bill will help farm workers?
No, this bill helps farm workers. Like I said, if a farm worker has worked in the farm and he died in the farm, that bill allows the farm workers to bury their beloved one in that farm. But we've got, as I said, we've got white racist farmers. When you die, your parents or you have worked in the farm, they will tell you that, no, you're not gonna, you must go and find a graveyard somewhere else. When you have born there, you were born in that farm, you grew up in that farm, you're almost 60, 75 years in that farm, and you died in that farm. You've got no any other place to go. That bill, it does allow you to have that, those rights. And COSATU, we have taken some of the farmers to court and they've lost cases. I can give example of the Northwest.
Please do.
Sorry?
I'm saying please do give an example.
Yeah. In the Northwest, I think we had about 4 or 5 farmers where farm workers died in the, worked in the farm for most about 30 to 40 years. When they're supposed to bury their refuse, we took them to court and they lost the case. Where the case in Swartrechens, where the case in the area called Tihani, in next to Tlekstop, Ottersdal, Delareyville, and Freiburg, where we had those cases, and that act was used in court, and the farmer lost the case. The other problem, I think the other thing that can help those with the act that can help workers that even if you are no longer in that farm, you have got some RTP or something, the act does allow you to visit the grave.
Mm-hmm.
It does allow a farm worker that, you know, those white racist people, when you grow in the farm, you've got children, then your children goes out and work somewhere. They're not supposed to visit you. That act does allow you. Its problem is that the implementation of that act is in piecemeal, is not fully implemented in terms of what is supposed to happen. So that act, it does help the farm workers, and also says when you are evicted in the farm, the farmer must either give you a piece of land in the farm, or where he's going to put you, you must have a roof over your head, children must be able to go to school, you must have access of water, electricity, and transport to go to work. That thing is normally not happening because some councillors, municipalities, they want to take responsibility of that supposed to be taken by farmers. And that thing, I've been argued with them, and says it's not your responsibility. It's the responsibility of the farmer because he's evicting that farmer. For the fact that he has worked for over 70 to 80 years, he has the responsibility to make sure that the farm worker get a house.
Now, let me be clear. Are you saying that should a farm worker who has been working on a farm and they have a family and they pass away, now the family of the deceased, they have a right to be able to claim from the farmer a piece of land or be provided for in terms of accommodation and all
that? Yes, that's what the act says.